The Toyota Sequoia TRD Pro is a beast designed to conquer mountains, dominate trails, and leave mud in its wake. But what happens if you want to try it like everybody will drive it on the chaos of city streets? Well, buckle up, my friends. Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racer, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, this TRD Pro is the Sequoia I want to drive, and I really wanted to take it off-road. Alas, I could not do that, and later in the episode, I'll tell you why, and it's not for reasons that you would think. Very unfortunate. But nonetheless, we're going to adapt this TRD Pro to the city that I live in, where the roads are horrific, and that's not a bad test of this TRD Pro to begin with, but I'm very curious how it works in the city. And before we get into what this is like to drive, let's have a look at this in a little more depth. As some of you may know, we've already driven the Sequoia Capstone. That was enjoyable, but this is the one I've really wanted to try because it has all of the special TRD Pro bits. This one uses the 3.5 liter V6 with two turbos. This is a hybrid, of course, as you know. The total power unit makes 437 horsepower at 5,200 RPM and 583 pounds of torque from 2,000 to 3,600 RPM. Transmission's a 10-speed automatic. This is four-wheel drive, of course. There is a two-speed electronically controlled transfer case. There's a locking rear diff. Does have Toyota's multi-terrain select, crawl control, and a bunch of other features that we'll talk about later. There is a skid plate and the LED light bar that is specific to the TRD Pro. Steering is electrically assisted. Suspension is based around double wishbones at the front, and as you can see, there are some special TRD Pro bits in there. Rear suspension's a live axle, but then you get into the TRD Pro specific stuff. There are the Fox internal bypass dampers with remote reservoir dampers at the rear. Brakes are four piston calipers at the front, single piston at the rear. Wheels are proper forged BBSs, and they are stunners. They're specific to the TRD Pro. Tires are 33-inch Falcon Wild Peaks, and they are 285 wide. Curb weight of this TRD Pro Sequoia is 6,150 pounds, and this will actually tow a tick over 9,000 pounds. Did you know that about 80% of you are not subscribed? Yes, it's true. I checked the data and 80% of you are not subscribed. So if you enjoy the content on this channel, do me a solid, hit that subscribe button. While you're at it, be sure to like this video and share it. And if you don't mind, drop by our merch store. There's lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Now back to your regularly scheduled episode. This interior is very similar to the Tundras and the Sequoia that we've driven previously, and it is fantastic in nearly every way. Number one, I love how rugged this interior is, and with this Softex upholstery, it's spot on for this TRD Pro. After that, it's very much Sequoia. There's this large steering wheel, as you'd expect in Sequoia and Tundra, but there's lots of adjustment in the steering column and in this big comfortable seat so that you can get set up perfectly behind the wheel. Great relationship to the pedals as well. Nice dead pedal for your left foot, which is important for a vehicle like this, which is capable of going deep, deep off-road. After that, it's pretty straightforward, standard stuff. The ergonomics are very, very straightforward. First level, second level, third level ergonomics, really straightforward. There's no learning curve here. The infotainment system is fantastic. I just use it on wireless CarPlay, and I'm very, very happy with that. Now, the thing about visibility is in the city, this hood line is very, very high. This sort of cowl height is very, very high. It's very difficult to see little people, people on bicycles, pedestrians, dogs even. So what I found myself doing is hitting the camera button here on the dash so I can see exactly what's ahead of me. And that's the smart thing to do. So if you're going to drive one of these in the city, you're definitely going to get accustomed to using that switch and getting that display up so you can see what's up close in front of you in an urban environment. After that, once you're here in the seat, you can see everywhere in all directions. With respect to storage, I've got one complaint, and it's not what you think. Space is abundant here, and there's lots of storage for everything you can imagine, and it's well thought out. No trouble finding places for your stuff in the Sequoia, whether it's in the front row or the second row or underneath the tailgate. No trouble at all. And on top of that, it's very, very spacious in this first row, second row as well, third row is kind of tiny. That's definitely for smaller humans. The third row is best left folded flat, so you can take advantage of all that space behind the tailgate. Now, my complaint about storage has to do with the roof rack. And I don't know why you'd need a roof rack in this Sequoia. It's enormous. You can put all of your stuff inside this thing. If you disagree, let me know in the comments, but I don't think there's any need for that roof rack. That roof rack just has a whole bunch of negatives. One, there's lots of wind noise at moderate speeds. I don't know, we're doing 50 miles an hour here, and you can hear it on the highway. It gets a little louder. Of course, there's some aerodynamic drag as well, which will impact your fuel consumption. And again, there's no need for that roof rack. You should be able to put all your stuff inside the Sequoia. For me, this Sequoia TRD Pro has two highlights. One is this powerful power unit. The other we'll get into later. I just love this power unit because it is a hybrid, but it is tuned a little bit more for performance than it is efficiency. And this is very, very quick off the line. It'll do 0 to 60 in like 5.5 seconds. It's very quick off the line. And on top of that, the abundance of torque is useful pretty much everywhere in day-to-day driving. So there's no trouble accelerating any time you need it. This is just a brilliant power unit, and when it's paired to the 10-speed automatic, it's just delightful. Funny thing is, in the several days I've had this Sequoia TRD Pro in my care, I have not had the opportunity to try the four-wheel drive system. Not in four-wheel drive, not in four-wheel drive low either. I've just been driving it around as we are in too high. Nonetheless, next time we try one of these, I'm definitely taking it off-road. And speaking of off-road, I really want to try the multi-terrain select and the other off-road modes here to see what these systems actually do, because we do have the suspension and we do have the tire that's capable of taking us off-road. Another funny thing that Toyota loves doing with their TRD Pros is making their mufflers a little bit louder. And in the 4Runner TRD Pro, I'm definitely not a fan of that. This one is a little louder than the previous Sequoia we tested. However, thankfully, due to the turbos, it's a little quieter. I don't think I would change it, but that constant little rumble is always there, but it's not as annoying as it is in the 4Runner TRD Pro, thankfully. The thing with some off-road tuned suspensions, and this one is very, very legitimate, oftentimes there are compromises, and that often leads to on-road handling suffering, and that is not the case here. On the road, this is delightful. The suspension is compliant, ride is comfortable and compliant, and there's not a lot of extra secondary motion here. Given that this is a little over 6,000 pounds, I'm really surprised, but they've done a fantastic job engineering and refining the suspension. And don't forget, this is the real deal. There's a lot of TRD Pro specific stuff. Particularly, we have to pay attention to the dampers. These Fox dampers do an excellent job in every way, and that's whether we're cruising on the freeway, crossing railroad tracks like we're doing here, or absorbing some bigger road imperfections, whether those are potholes, speed bumps, curbs. I've done it all with the Sequoia TRD Pro, and it doesn't complain at all, and that's all credit due to the suspension. This is one fantastic suspension. Yes, there's a little bit more compliance in this tire as well, because it is a TRD Pro spec tire, and it is also fantastic. Really want to try it off-road, but even on-road, it's quiet, comfortable, and does absorb these impacts, helps the suspension absorb some bigger impacts, so that you pretty much don't have to worry about hitting anything in the Sequoia TRD Pro. It'll soak up just about everything, and I mean, when we take it over speed bumps, this thing does not complain at all. Steering is a little bit on the slower side. This is derived from the Tundra, of course, so it's a little bit slower. And then when we talk about turning radius, well, that's another thing altogether. The best way to say it is that the turning radius of this Sequoia TRD Pro is bigger than your ex's body count, so choose your parking spots wisely. Otherwise, otherwise steering effort is fairly light, and it is direct and precise as it's going to be in a 6,000 pound SUV. Thankfully, braking is exceptionally confidence inspiring. I've got great control on the brake pedal, and you've got tremendous confidence in the power of these brakes as well. No complaints about the brakes. I would like to tow with this to see how those brakes react to that situation, but I think they're going to be up to par. With this suspension setup and the fact this is a tall SUV and it weighs a lot, do expect a lot of body roll, but it is well controlled, much thanks to the dampers. The dampers are wonderfully calibrated and they control that roll as well as just overall ride quality and body and wheel motion exceptionally well. These are kind of at a next level compared to what we've experienced in the 4Runner TRD Pro. Those are great, but these seem like they're engineered at the next level. And I do have to say the engineering that has turned this Sequoia into a TRD Pro is absolutely exceptional. This thing is a joy to drive, and I have the confidence to take it anywhere I want to go. How do you spec yours? Well, that's fairly easy because here in Canada, there are no options. In the US, there are just two to consider, and that's more to your personal taste than anything else. What you are looking at is the signature Terra paint that's only available on the TRD Pro and the black Softex interior. In the US, base price is $79,110. In Canada, it's $95,500, and that's before freight and local taxes. In Canada, this is the way it comes. In the US, your two options are the panoramic sunroof and the power tow mirror option. They are available separately, I believe, and given that this will tow over 9,000 pounds, it's definitely worth considering those mirrors if you're towing. But otherwise, with your Sequoia TRD Pro, all you need to do is pick your colors and be happy. And I will say that this Terra paint is absolutely striking, and as we know, it's a signature paint for the 2024 Sequoia TRD Pro. Might not be a bad choice at all. My verdict? Well, off the top of this segment, we usually talk about fuel consumption, but because I don't have anything meaningful to report, because I only had been driving this in the city and a little out here to the country, my mileage is definitely not scientific. I'm not going to report on it, but rest assured I'm using plenty of fuel because I am enjoying the throttle of the Sequoia TRD Pro. And off the top, I told you I'd let you know why this episode is not being shot off-road, and that's because I've been terribly ill all week, but I have managed to put it together and get out here to the countryside, get this episode shot. But another time, maybe for 2025, we'll take a Sequoia TRD Pro off-road. Nonetheless, as for this Sequoia TRD Pro, well, you can tell I really, really dig this thing. And that's because it does have one serious secret, and it's all in the suspension. It crushes all urban obstacles. Curbs, potholes, speed bumps, nothing matters. This thing crushes everything, and it does so comfortably for the occupants on board. Sure, it might not have conquered a backwoods trail today, but the TRD Pro's off-road pedigree translated beautifully to the city. Its rugged suspension handled every bump and uneven surface with complete aplomb, while that powerful V6 twin turbo hybrid power unit made merging, accelerating onto highways and even up to city speeds a total breeze. But it's not just about performance. The TRD Pro surprised me with its refinement, offering unexpected comfort and luxury features. It became a haven from the urban jungle and a bit of a sanctuary from the chaos outside. And for me, it's a couple of features shy of perfection. Yes, this exhaust drones a little bit more than the regular Sequoia, but it's not as bad as the 4Runner TRD Pro, so I probably wouldn't change the exhaust. But what I would do is absolutely get rid of that roof rack. I have no need for it, and as I discovered driving in the city, it's a little sketchy when you want to park this in underground parking structures because there's not a lot of clearance. But overall, I completely enjoy driving this thing, and when I'm healthy again, when we have some time, I'm really going to enjoy taking this one off-road. So is this TRD Pro all off-road hype, or can it be an off-road warrior? Well, I think it is for the rugged individualist with a bit of a sophisticated soul, and I really dig this thing. Anyway, hope you liked this episode, and if you did, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring, so please share this episode with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions, questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Toyota Sequoia TRD Pros.